ancient China, women were taught the values of childbirth as a means to carry down the family name. As a result, women were always trapped in a lowly position and oppressed by men. In the 2000 years following the Zhou Dynasty, the implementation of the private ownership system overthrew the short-lived power of the women and emphasized the control of leadership positions by men. Therefore, the women's place in society plummeted several thousand leagues. In the following years, the overall status of women in society remained low-lying, even though women put up an unrelenting fight. Unfair treatment of women remained in society, even in the Qing dynasties. Due to Chinese culture and societal developments, men were deemed more important and more needed than women. Food mining started to become popular, and women were obliged to accept this cruel treatment due to cultural values. In royal families, many female servants were forced to marry eunuchs and denied the right to occupy leading positions, such as ministers or commanders. In modern China, new policies have been implemented to abolish the old treatment, but inequality and gender stereotypes still exist, and are sometimes even more extensive than before. Female babies are often seen to be a burden to the family that has to raise them up, while male babies are often seen as a boon that is desired by all. Even if a family already has 4 or 5 girls, the parents will still strive for a boy. Here's a video that reflects the female inequality in the past China.
老刘这小子真行啊，这回又得了个男人，说不准明年他们家还得围上一圈。我看还是把换地送人吧，拉尿都拉不到墙上边。
This phenomenon started to emerge towards the end of the 1950s as living conditions grew better for Chinese citizens. As a result, China's population has seen a great increase ever since the 1970s. The one-child policy passed by the government in the 1980s regulates and adjusts the huge population of China by restricting a family to only have one child and hoping to allow more gender equality in society. However, this policy leads to high rates of sex-selective abortion. According to the research, the data of aborting or abandoning female infants is outrageous. Furthermore, many parents who desired a son but had a daughter often failed to report or delayed reporting female births to the authorities. This phenomenon is due to the conservative ideas of Chinese people. Men are supposed to be stronger, while women were considered as baby machines. Meanwhile, the Chinese government tried to ameliorate such situation. Women's education has caught its attention. In China, women can hardly have their own rights during the time before the 21st century. Women were properties of men. The cruelest reality was that women were forced to obey those unfair rules, treatment, and discrimination. Women were not allowed to study, not to mention works. In the late Qing Dynasty, the Chinese government was under European countries' control and was forced to embrace the thoughts of gender equality. Traditional concepts such as men are superior to women influenced China over years were raised into the ground. is the time when Chinese feminism emerged. Chinese self and women's schools were set up in the late Qing Dynasty, and more Chinese feminists stood up for their own voices, advocating their own natural rights. During the Revolution of 1911, a great number of feminists emerged. A famous female leader named Qiu Jing declared the liberation of Chinese women. Xiang Jingyu, who was another leader of the movement of women's liberation, as well as the feminist pioneer after Qiu Jing, established the first co-ed school in Hunan province and cultivated a lot of talents. By the start of the Republic of China, women started to take part in education as more people became literate and reasonable. In 1913, the Christian Church of America founded China's first all-women's school, Jingling Women's College.
没有物质大学，没那个男女分得很清楚，所以就没有地方念书。后来打听到京女大在南京，已经开了。我姐姐的写信回来就是讲，教师怎么好，怎么认真教学，我的脑子里我觉得，哎呀，这他去的是很好的一个地方，将来我也知道那边。那就是我母亲十多岁结婚，一方面年轻，年龄差的也很多。同时他要念书，所以他就争取，可以说是革命性的跟家里头当时闹翻了，自己跑到上海来继续念书那样。
In 1921, Chinese female periodicals emerged endlessly. Among these, Labor and Women was the most representative magazine, and it started its publication in Guangzhou, announcing labor and women liberation.As women gradually gained support, several female leaders not only led the revolution of education, but also the rise of female sports. Therefore, more women were more educated and were able to work and did not have to depend on their husbands anymore. Most of them worked in factories. Yes, despite the improvements women have met these 20 years, many men still believe that it is unnecessary for women to work, so women are still denied equal attention in some places. Many women still occupy jobs with low income but high labor requirements in order to maintain their current rights and living styles. Before 21st century, many Chinese women who wanted to work outside mostly were feminists and the lower classes.After the Second World War, the Chinese government implemented New York policies for all its citizens. Women gained economic rights and were allowed better working conditions. The Women's Federation was established, and women were united against their common enemy. However, sexism towards women by men still existed, and successful women were few in number despite the increasing employment of women.In 2014, Bain and Company had discovered that with 73% of working-age women currently employed, China became one of the highest female employment rates in the world. Women now tend to be as qualified as men when they enter the workforce, receiving the same amount of paycheck, having the opportunity to compete with men, being promoted in any time.Women can be professors, businesswomen, scientists, and so on. They can enter various career fields they interest. Yes, based on Bain and Company's research, only 17% of senior managers, 6% of CEOs, and 8% of board directors were females, much lower than would be expected. Gender bias still exists.For almost 2,000 years, the women of China have been fighting for equal rights much like the women of other countries have been fighting for change and reform. This is neither a short nor an easy task. As gender equality issues grow larger in society, more and more people are becoming affiliated with this situation.
为妇女争取权利吧，那因为从历史上来讲是一个男权的社会， 然后女权不管是在中国还是在国外的话，我们这个妇女在历史上权利都是低，社会地位相对比较低的这么一个阶层，所以我觉得女权的这个运动呢，其实有助于增加妇女的自信心，然后呢增加妇女的社会地位，我觉得这是一个未来世界发展的一个趋势。
在中国可能目前为止声音还不是很大。
我觉得现在好多那个都在说什么，喊的口号都说是什么维护女权主义什么什么的，其实他不管他喊的口号有多响亮，你知道吧，其实女人是比较容易受伤害的。
现在不一直都是女权主义吗？
No country in the world can yet say that they have achieved gender equality. These rights I consider to be human rights. Both men and women should feel free to be sensitive. Both men and women should feel free to be strong. It is time that we all perceive gender on a spectrum instead of two sets of opposing ideals.By what we are not, and start defining ourselves by who we are, we can all be freer. And this is what he for she is about. It's about freedom.
In a world that no longer needs women's rights movements, and women no longer need to fight, can women really gain the rights they deserve?